Come on, everybody all over the room, open your mouth and worship him. Lift your hands and bless him in this place.
Your simple song. Say, my hallelujah. From the bottom of your heart, lift your voice. My hallelujah.
Good evening. Amen. Good evening. We want to welcome you to Restoring Souls to Christ Radio with your radio host, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson, and we get ready for a powerful message on this evening. Amen. Hopefully it will bless you, pick up your spirits. Amen. Hallelujah. We give God glory and honor just to be back here once again. And we thank you for tuning in. Share this on your Facebook page, Instagram page, Twitter page, or any other social media outlet that you have, and invite your neighbors, invite your mama, invite your daddy, granddaddy, amen, your brother, sister, your children, invite them all in to tune in every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock. Amen. So we gonna give the woman of God another hand clap as she come on and bring the message to us. Amen. Let's come on.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Welcome to Restoring Souls Back to Christ radio broadcast. I am your host for the evening, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson from Duncanville, Texas. Tonight, I thank God for being back in your midst again. I praise him for another opportunity to give you what he has given me to share, and I pray that it blesses your very soul. Glory to God. But before we go into the word of God, let's go before the throne of grace. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, on tonight I give you honor, I give you glory, and I give you praise. I thank you on tonight, God, for another opportunity to come before your people to deliver your word in the name of Jesus. I praise you on tonight, God, and I ask that you bless your people through the word that you bring through me tonight, and help me to let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Holy Spirit, have your way in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. We're going to go into the word of God tonight, coming from the book of Matthew, the 25th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Matthew 25, beginning at the first verse. And it reads, "Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, 'Behold, the bridegroom cometh. Go ye out to meet him.'" Verse 7, Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, Give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, Not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. Glory to God. But go ye rather to them that sell, and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward came also the other virgins, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, Verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. Glory to God. Glory to God. The thought I want to share with you on tonight is, don't be foolish. Glory to God. Don't be foolish. If you know you have the Holy Ghost, don't be foolish. If you know that you're walking in your calling that God called you to do, don't be foolish. In this scripture tonight, it says that there were 10 virgins. And the revelation I got from this is they were all clean, all saved, but all did not receive the Holy Ghost after they were clean or saved. Glory to God. In Matthew 12, 44 and 45, it tells us that if we get saved and don't receive the Holy Spirit, that the unclean spirit that came out of us will go about wandering around in dry places, seeking rest. It's got to have somewhere to go to. When it leaves you, once you give your life to the Lord, when it leaves you, when that spirit that was in you leave you, it goes out to seek another person to, it has to have a host, what we call a host. So the spirit has to have a host. So this spirit, this unclean spirit goes out seeking rest and find none. So he says to himself, I will return back to my house. He calls it his house, where from which I came. Glory to God. So it will behoove us that those of us that get saved, that we seek the Holy Spirit, because it's a keeping power. It'll keep out unclean spirits that may have left you. Glory to God. So don't be foolish. Seek the Holy Spirit. Don't be foolish. Some people think they can ride on your anointing and only your prayers, but don't be foolish. You can't get to heaven on a credit. You have to have the Holy Spirit. You have to know the Lord and the pardon of your sins. You have to be ready when he calls your name. So don't be foolish. Some people even think they can copy your dance or your praise and make it into heaven. But don't be foolish. That's not how it works. We have to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling. So saints, let's not be foolish. The five foolish virgins thought they could get saved and just hang around the five wise and not do the work of seeking the Holy Spirit and still make it into heaven. Not so. We must receive him for ourselves and not be foolish. Glory to God. So I just stopped by for a little while to let you know that if we're not walking wisely, let's start. If we are walking wisely, let's continue. So when the bridegroom comes, we won't be left behind. Glory to God. And we won't be looking foolish. Glory to God. So in these verses of scripture, I picture in my mind the bride getting ready to meet her groom. Now, when you plan a wedding, you have to have everything in order. You have to have your shoes just right. You have to have your dress just right. You have to have your veil, whatever, however you want it set up. But you have to be dressed properly. You can't wait until the last minute and say, oh, you're almost at the altar where your bridegroom is, where your groom is. You're almost at the altar where he is. And the wedding ceremony is about to begin. And you say, I forgot my shoes, or I forgot my veil. You need to be ready and not be foolish. So as it is in the spirit, so as it is in the natural. So in the spirit wise, once we get saved, it would be a wise thing to seek the Holy Spirit as soon as we receive the Lord as our Lord and Savior. Because if we don't, when the bridegroom comes back, which is Jesus Christ, when he comes back for his church, we'll be like the foolish virgin and we won't be ready. And I believe that these foolish virgins, they were saved women, they were clean women, but they did not have oil for their lamps. And in my mind's eye, I said the oil for the lamp, the oil is the Holy Spirit. They chose to get saved, but they didn't choose to keep the fire burning by fasting and praying and seeking God's face and getting close to him and reading his word. So people of God, don't be like the five foolish. Be like the five wise and study the word of God. Read the word of God. Trust God's word. Fast and pray that, and so you could be full of the Holy Spirit. Seek the Holy Spirit. So when the Lord comes back, if you are sleeping in the natural and the Lord comes back and called your name and you don't have the quickening power, that same quickening power that woke Jesus up from the dead, you're going to be left behind. And you're going to be knocking. You could be wondering, okay, Lord, why I can't come in? I prayed, I lay hands on people and they recovered. I cast out demons in your name and people were set free. But because you were not ready, because you acted foolishly and didn't seek the Holy Spirit, you can't come in. He said, I don't even know you. Who are you? But Lord, I was a pastor of this big cathedral and I had thousands and thousands of members. He said, but who are you? I don't know you. But Lord, I had the gift of prophecy. I had the word of knowledge. I had all the gifts that you had given me. And I did it in your name. But the Lord said, I don't know you. You've been foolish with the gifts. You use my gift for your gain, to make money, to make yourself look good. You wanted the glory, and you were foolish. You were foolish with what I gave you. You didn't use it wisely. When I told you to be still, you wanted to do your own thing and go where you wanted to go and do what you wanted to go. And I'm telling you, not now. This is not the time. But you wouldn't hear me. You wanted to be foolish and go your own way. So we see, going back to these 10 virgins, it didn't say they won't say, because in my mind, when you say virgin, that means clean, never been touched. So you're pure. But they did not receive the Holy Spirit. They didn't have oil in their lamps. You can look pretty on the outside. You can look saved on the outside, because the word of God declares having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, you're being foolish. People of God, the times that we're living in on today, it behooves us, speaking to me first, giving it out to you. We all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But if we be wise like the five wise virgins and have oil in our vessels, glory to God. When he call our name, it will quicken us and we'll be able to go back with the bridegroom. Because Jesus told us, I have gone away to prepare a place for you. And where I'll be, you can come with me. I'm preparing this place for you. Because in my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. So don't be foolish and miss out on the marriage to the bridegroom. Glory to God. Seek the Holy Spirit. Let's seek the Lord with all of our heart, all of our mind, all of our soul, everything within us. And if you haven't done it, let's start doing it. And if you are doing it, don't stop. Glory to God. We're in a battle for our very souls and the souls of others. Because the time is at hand. The end of all things is at hand. We're coming to the close of the day. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And we don't need to be foolish. Things are beginning to happen. And the Bible is being revealed on a daily basis. So let's not be foolish. Let's take heed at what God is telling us. Let's take heed if he tells us that they shall say peace and there will be sudden destruction. Believe God's word and don't be foolish. Let's get our house in order. Glory to God. Let's seek God like never before. Like I said, I'm talking to me first. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. I love the Lord. I love the Lord, and he knows that I love him. I want you to know that we can love the Lord and serve him with gladness. Serving God is not a sad, gloomy life. Glory to God. And you don't have to be foolish. Glory to God. If you listen to the Holy Spirit, if you receive the Holy Spirit, he said he's a teacher and a guide. Glory to God. He'll bring things back to your remembrance that God have told you before. Glory to God. So let's not be foolish tonight. Let's seek God. Let's ask him to come into our lives to help us and help us to surrender all to him. Our mind and our bodies. Because Paul said in Romans, I beseech you, I beg you, brother, I ask you, brothers and sisters, it's our reasonable service that we present our bodies living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. That's the least we can do for all that he's done for us. So let's not be foolish. Let's not be like the five foolish virgins that found everything else to do after they got saved. They just set, I'm saying this in a figurative way, they may have set their lamps down, burned it at high speed for a long time. And then when the bridegroom came to get them, they weren't ready. Their lamps had gone out. They said, our lamps have gone out. We don't have any more oil. We went to sleep and we was ready, we thought. Glory to God. But you didn't have enough keeping power that when he called your name, you weren't ready. But those that were ready were able to go into the marriage with the bridegroom. Now, how would it feel if it was you in the natural and you prepared for your wedding day? You were all dressed and ready. And when it came time for you to meet your groom, you couldn't meet him. It was a block there. It was something that keeping you from your groom, your husband. Let's not be foolish. Let's not be foolish. My cry today is that we all be ready when Jesus comes. Glory to God. Because he don't want any of us to perish. That's the kind of God we serve. Because if he wanted us to perish, he would not have sent his son down here to go through what he went through for us. To be crucified, to be spit upon, to be dragged, to be treated the way he was treated. And then his prayer, Jesus' prayer was in the Garden of Gethsemane, Lord, if it be your will, let this bitter cup, don't let me have to go through this cross, to this cross and do what you sent me here to do. If it be your will, let this bitter cup pass me by. But Father, not my will, but your will be done. I know what my purpose was. So if God wanted us to perish, he would not allow his son, his only begotten son, to come down here and go through what he went through for us if he wanted us to perish. So people of God, my brothers and my sisters, those of you that may not know Jesus in the pardon of your sin, get to know him. Cry out to him. And once you get to know him in the pardon of your sin and ask him to become the Lord of your life, receive ye the Holy Spirit, the keeping power. Because Jesus told his disciples, when I leave you, I won't leave you comfortless. You're going to have the Holy Spirit. The Spirit's going to come from me, and it's going to teach you my ways. You'll still know my ways. You'll still know the ways of the Father through the Holy Spirit. So people of God, my brothers and my sisters, my cry tonight is, don't be foolish. Let's get ready. Let's get ready. Because Jesus is on his way back. And I know some of you say, well, we've been hearing that all our lives and he ain't got back yet. Well, I want you to know, with the love of God in my heart, I want you to know, because I want you to be saved as well and meet the bridegroom in peace. The door don't be shut in your face. I want you to know that his coming is closer today than it was yesterday. The signs are in the air. We're living in the book of Revelation. So don't be foolish and miss the wedding. Glory to God. Don't be foolish and miss the wedding, because Jesus is coming back. He's coming back. He's a man of his word. If he told you he was coming back for us, he's coming back. So let's not be foolish. Glory to God. Glory to God. God bless you. Father, in the name of Jesus, on tonight I pray that somebody will cry out, what must I do to be saved? What must I do that the door will not be shut in my face when Jesus comes? In the name of Jesus. So I ask that you bless your people, God. Those that are lost, I pray that they come to know you in the pardon of their sin. I pray that something was said on tonight for your glory that will draw them, because you said if you be lifted up from the earth, you will draw all men unto you, not unto me, but unto you. Glory to God. And on tonight, God, I ask that you bless the listeners of this radio broadcast. Bless their very soul. Meet their needs, God. Let them want to know you even the more. For it is in Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Glory to God. I thank you once again for joining us tonight. I pray that you come back and join us again next Wednesday night, the same time at 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 7 p.m. Central Time. And I pray that you tell a friend, tell a neighbor that the Lord is still restoring souls back to him. He's still crying out. There's still time. Glory to God. So let somebody know that the Lord still loves them. He still loves them, and he has need of them. So I thank God on tonight. And I want to thank God for Pastor Nino and the TMA radio station for allowing us this platform. It's been a little over a year, and I'm so thankful. I thank God for this opportunity. Glory to God. And I want to thank God for our faithful sponsor. To God be the glory, Jewels out of Newport News, Virginia. For the proprietor is Minister Jackie Torian. Glory to God. And that number there is 757-272-4885. Again, that's To God be the glory, Jewels, proprietor Minister Jackie Torian out of Newport News, Virginia. The number is 757-272-4885. It's great jewelry. I am a fan of it. It's paparazzi jewelry, 100% nickel and lead free. You will look glorious like the queen that you are if you order with her. So get in touch with Miss Torian at that number. And God bless you. And until next time, be safe. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. That was Pastor Brenda D. Wilson on Restoring Souls to Christ Radio. We pray that you were blessed by the message on this evening. I tell you what, if you were blessed, share this on your Facebook page. Invite your friends, invite your neighbors, invite your church members to tune in each and every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock. Eastern Standard Time is 7 o'clock Central Time. And again, we love you with the love of the Lord here. And we thank God for each and every one of you. Listen, at 9 o'clock, we're getting ready for Men to Men Talk Back, the Talk Up Show with your radio host, Pastor Nino, and co-host, Pastor Carl Young. And tonight's conversation is the lying spirit. Oh, we should be a good one tonight. Lying spirit. And we know a lot of people got a lying tongue. Relationships got jokers lying to try to get you to do what they want you to do. And oh man, so much false prophets telling you lies. So we're going to talk about tonight, lying spirit, on Men to Men Talk Back to Talk Show at 9 o'clock. Want you to join us. And we want to say, hey, we had a winner last week, amen, for a special gift. That was Mother Rainford, amen, received a special gift, and we mailed it off to her today, amen. So she should be getting it before the weekend out, so that'll be just in time for her to get, you know, have a good weekend gift. I tell you this, I know it's going to be a good weekend gift if she get it by Friday, amen. So again, we thank all of y'all for tuning in and being a part of us. We're selecting random viewers every week. Somebody might get a special gift. So you never know. It might be you. So tune in at Men to Men, 9 o'clock. God bless you. And tune back in next week at 8 o'clock for Restoring Souls to Christ Radio with your radio host, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson. God bless you. And may heaven smile upon each and every one of you. I love you. Bye-bye now. Oh, yeah.
You leave this building, my prayer for everyone in here is that you'll have your healing. Once God works a miracle to feed your mended my
hallelujah. Come on, somebody praise him. I believe there's praise in the house.